In 2010, the Deepwater Horizon oil rig exploded, creating a huge seafloor oil gusher that lasted for 87 days and dumped 4.9 million barrels of crude oil into the ocean. Some places along the Gulf Coast are still dealing with the consequences of that spill. Fast forward to today, and we've got a similarly high-profile fuel leak. In California, natural gas is escaping through a ruptured pipe more than 1,000 feet underground. It started on October 23rd, and so far, nothing's been able to stop it. So, what's the difference? Which is worse, the BP oil spill or this Aliso Canyon gas leak? Now granted, they both suck, but it's a pretty great opportunity to compare the dangers of methane and natural gas pollution to an oil spill and its emissions. So let's get a little background on the Aliso Canyon gas leak, because it isn't being talked about as much as it should. For 2 months, it's been spewing gas about 1,100,000 pounds per hour. As of this filming, it's up to 86,770 total metric tons, but if you want to keep track yourself, the EDF has a live update of the estimated leakage. The leak is in a Southern California gas company's natural gas well in Aliso Canyon near the gated community of Porter Ranch. The well extracts gas from a reservoir about 8,000 feet below the surface. At first, folks thought it might be an issue with a seriously updated safety valve, but according to SoCal Gas, that valve was deemed unnecessary and removed previously because of its age. If it was still there and also functioning, the company could have shut off the well by now and we wouldn't be having this problem. Hey regulators, maybe consider changing these standards, please. So what exactly is leaking? Natural gas is, as the name would suggest, a naturally occurring hydrocarbon gas mixture comprised mainly of methane. You may know methane in connection with cow farts, which, yes, is an actual problem. Like other fossil fuels, natural gas is a result of highly pressurized and heated plant and animal materials and is often found near petroleum. As a fuel, natural gas tends to be better for the environment than burning crude oil, in terms of emissions. But when leaked directly into the atmosphere, it's a pure greenhouse gas, no combustion necessary. In fact, some sources put methane at more than 50 times more potent a greenhouse gas than carbon dioxide when it's first released, because it's better at trapping heat in our atmosphere. Aside from the possible global climate consequences, in the area about 2,800 households had to be relocated, and many have become ill from the smell, citing complaints of headaches, nausea, and other ailments. And along with that methane, tons of other nasties are leaking out of the hole. In recent days, SoCal Gas has been getting a lot of flack for dramatically underestimating the amount of benzene, a known carcinogen being released in the air from the leak, along with all the natural gas. In terms of recapturing the methane from the atmosphere, it's almost impossible. So the best that we can hope for is that SoCal Gas seals up the hole as quickly as possible, or builds some kind of containment measure. And that isn't going super well. Several attempts have already been made, and reports show that if anything, it's only gotten worse. Unfortunately, current projections aren't confident the leak will be sealed before the spring, which could mean another 80,000 metric tons of escaped methane in the atmosphere. By contrast, an oil spill like the Deepwater Horizon explosion doesn't do that much for the global atmosphere, the silver lining being that some of the fuel we spilled isn't going to be burned. But only about 3 of the 4.9 million barrels of spilled oil in the ocean was retrieved. Much of it coated wildlife, killing thousands, or still persists on beaches, the ocean floor, and wetlands to this day. Not to mention the economic effects on fishermen and other folks whose livelihoods rely on a healthy Gulf. It's still difficult even today to determine exactly what the long-term consequences of the BP spill will be. But back to the gas leak. The biggest bummer, because by most counts it's far more dangerous for our overall climate health, is how little notice people are paying. The gas leaking into the atmosphere is invisible. Unlike a giant oil spill in the ocean, there are no animals coated in oil to rile up the masses. Which means there isn't nearly the same public pressure to seal it as quickly as possible, and might mean even fewer future repercussions in terms of sanctions and fines leveled at the company and the natural gas industry as a whole to prevent another leak. The Aliso Canyon leak is not unique. This well is old, but so are a lot of other natural gas wells. While leaks this extreme are rare, major leakage across the oil and gas supply chain is not. This event just goes to show that SoCal Gas is not prepared for this kind of emergency, and more than likely, neither are other natural gas companies. Thanks so much for watching, I hope you liked the video. Let me know if you have any further questions about methane pollution versus crude oil, or want to chat about the pros and cons of natural gas. Also, feel free to suggest a topic for a future video in the comments down below. Like the video if you liked it, subscribe if you want to see more things like this, and I hope you're having a fantastic day. Bye!